Last night I thought I was dreaming, 'cause things like you don't usually happen to me. Outside the stars were the ceiling, we sang to the moon, then we danced underneath. I felt so hard, but you kissed so soft. I felt my heart couldn't beat enough. You pulled me closer and called my bluff. I am in love, I am enough.
Sleeping in on Sunday morning, I am lying next to you. Darling, if we fall in sparks, we'll fly and ignite the fuse like dynamite.
We are exploding colors that shine, purple and green and red in the sky. Love is unfolding before us.
Crow Park. Have you guys had a good time tonight?
That's good to hear.
Well, sadly, it has come to that time of night where we got to say goodbye.
I know.
But before we do that, we have a few things that we'd like to say. You know, growing up as a child, everybody has a dream. And my dream as a young guy was to be in a band and make albums, play concerts, tour around the world. And I went to school, I bumped into two classmates, and we formed a little band back in Sligo. And then we made a little CD, and Shane's mum, May, who's here tonight, she sent that CD to a man called Louis Walsh. Louis, 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 Louis. And Louis, gave us a call and said, come on up to Dublin and meet us. So we went up to Dublin, and 2 weeks later he had us supporting the Backstreet Boys, and we were huge fans of the Backstreet Boys back then. And we couldn't believe it. We thought, wow, this is the best thing we'll ever do. If it goes no further than the Backstreet Boys, we're happy with that. Then we fast forward a few years later, and we met two Dublin guys, and Westlife was born. And you know, when Westlife was born, we thought, wow, we have a real shot at this. Went across to London, we met Steve Mack, we recorded Swear It Again and Flying Without Wings, and before we knew it, we were having number ones. And then all of a sudden, we had so many number ones, so many top tens, it was incredible. And then it all came to an end in this very building 7.5 years ago. And we truly felt like that was the end. We thought we were saying goodbye forever. But that didn't happen, did it? And you know, when we met up again for the first time as a band and discussed the idea of Westlife getting back together, we thought, yeah, maybe we'll play a few shows in the Three Arena or something like that. But never did we imagine, Dublin, that we'd be selling out this place two nights in a row again. So thank you to each and every single person in here. Thank you for making our dream come true, not just once, but twice. And hey, here's to another 20 years, yeah? Because as Nicky said, we have a brand new album coming, and we feel like this is one of the best albums we've ever made. Westlife 2.0 has been born, and trust me, we ain't going nowhere. I have to say a very special shout out to two very special ladies who are here tonight. My mom, I love you, mom. And my wife, Jody. Hi, baby, I love you so much. And to all the Westlife family, the Westlife family is continuously growing. We have 9 children here and 1 on the way, Marky boy. And you know, it's so great to see the future. They were up here on stage with us last night, such an amazing moment. But you know, it's all about family, Croke Park. That's what we live for. We live for family. And a few years ago, 10 years ago now this year, I lost my dad, Kevin, who I know is looking down on us tonight. And we had some hard times. A few months later, Nicky lost his dad, Nico Sr. We also know he's looking down on us tonight. And you know, my mum-in-law, Eileen, we lost her a few years later. And it's these moments that you realize what family is and what family is all about. And all of us in here, we all go through hard times in life and we all lose people. And it's one of the hardest things in life. But this next song, I think, is a song that rings true to family and to love and to what we all do for each other in our daily lives. So please sing along with us, Croke Park. This is called You Raise Me Up.